I get it down on the dance floor. Watch this.
If you're a marketer, an analyst, or an executive and you're data-driven, or you like your organization to be more data-driven, you're going to love this. Google Analytics Premium data can be available in Google BigQuery. What does that mean for you? You'll have very granular data available to you. You'll have hit-level data from web analytics, and then you can stitch it with data from your campaign, data from your offline sources, data from your CRM to answer very tough and complex business and marketing questions. So let's do a quick walkthrough of BigQuery and show how we can analyze massive amount of data sets in seconds. You can use the web interface here and compose a query on the fly. You can use your own data set, your Google Analytics data, or for our purposes here, we'll just maybe play around with Wikipedia and click on compose query and enter here. Let's say we want to look at titles by contributor, by username, and also get a list of the number of characters. And we'll put maybe some parameters, let's say the item IDs from 1 to 10,000 and say run query. And you see here on, you know, real time, it's going through gigabytes of data, you know, millions of rows of data, and it will then, the tool, BigQuery, will spit out the good information that we're looking for. It might take us a few more seconds, but again, think of the massive amount of rows of data that it is, you know, processing on the fly here as we speak. So see what we have. It took us about 41 seconds. 14 gigabytes of data were processed, and then we have the results right here. And then you can go through, about 5 million or so results. So that's very powerful, and that's what we can do. What we want to show next is an actual use case, how we've connected different data sources, and we leverage BigQuery to answer that question in a B2B environment in terms of the cost of a qualified lead. So in this use case, we look at the data sources we have. We have web analytics data, Google Analytics, you know, page views, time on site, conversion, you name it. We also have paid search data, AdWords and Bing and other type paid search campaigns, and associated metrics such as impressions and cost per click and other useful metrics. We also have CRM data. This is from Salesforce or maybe some internal CRM system that you're using. And then we have campaign cost data as well. We want to tie all this together into a meaningful report that we can then analyze. So we have all those data points in BigQuery. And what we're doing here is we're trying to look at the performance of these campaigns. So for example, we have a campaign for a software demo running on Bing and one running on Google. So you'll see here that we have data from AdWords, from Bing Ads. We have the campaign cost and we have the campaign name. And then the second two columns, or the second column here, is you'll see analytics data. This is coming from Google Analytics, and we're looking for now for an engagement metric such as average time on site or time duration. And then here you'll see the data that we will pull from Salesforce.com, and this is the number of qualified leads. Again, on the web, we wouldn't know if somebody fills out a form and submits a form, we wouldn't know if this was a qualified lead. Obviously, also when someone clicks on an ad in AdWords, we're not sure if they're going to convert or not, and we're not sure if they're going to be a qualified lead. But in your CRM system, your salesperson, or maybe through your lead scoring or marketing automation system, you score leads based on specific criteria and you know they're qualified. So here we have these three disparate data sets: your campaign data, your web analytics data, and then your Salesforce data. And then we stitch those together in BigQuery, and you get this awesome metric that is the not only the number of qualified leads, but the cost per qualified lead. And we know here for sure that this number one campaign now is bringing us leads at half the rate at the second campaign. So we can maybe go and expand on that channel, pay a little bit more money upfront to acquire more leads. Now, that's not the end of it. Let's say we have a lot more data. Let's say we have also in our own system, in our own system, we do have the names of the leads. We have also other attributes, maybe the emails that have been sent to, or maybe how many emails they've opened. So assuming you have a little bit more data points on the leads, we can put all of that in BigQuery, and then we can show it, we can report on it, and apply, leverage something like Tableau to visualize the data in a more meaningful way. And then for this dashboard, this is courtesy of Tableau, you'll see that in this example, you'll see that we have email data, blue here. On top, you have green data, is how many emails have been viewed, click-throughs, and then the orange row here is this number of visits to the website, and then the purple is the forms that the visitors submitted. And you can tie all this together and show here the level of activity, the individual activity of your leads. And you can obviously act on this data. So that first lead, you see a lot of orange, a lot of blue. They're very active. They're very involved. They're checking their emails. They're coming and visiting the website. So it's time for the salesperson to go out and reach out to them. And on the left-hand side, and I'll conclude with this, you can also aggregate the leads maybe back to the company name. So not only we can report on the number of leads or the number of qualified leads, but we're also reporting on the number of leads per company. And this is super useful in a B2B environment where you might have a technical person looking at your website, then maybe your purchasing person and maybe an executive, you know, different personas, different user behavior, but we can stitch it all together and report at the company level as well as in the individual level. Very powerful stuff. You can leverage, again, the integration between Google Analytics Premium and BigQuery to get that useful web data. You can also bring in more data sources. And then at the very last step here, you can visualize what you have in a very meaningful and actionable way. Thank you so much. And we look forward to see you on the next video. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions about BigQuery, about Google Analytics Premium, or just analytics in general, drop us a line, email us at info@enor.com, that's e-nor.com, or leave us a comment. Thank you.